नरेंद्र मोदी। वी ऑलवेज सी पीपल टॉकिंग अबाउट हिज पास्ट एज ही वॉज अ टी सेलर इन हिज चाइल्डहुड, बट डू वी रियली नो अबाउट हिज जर्नी? दिस वीडियो इज अबाउट द जर्नी ऑफ नरेंद्र मोदी फ्रॉम सेलिंग टी एट रेलवे एंड बस स्टेशन टू बिकमिंग द प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ आवर कंट्री। Born on 17 September 1950 in Vadnagar, Mehsana district in Gujarat, Narendra Modi was the third child of his father Damodar Das Moolchand Modi and mother Hiraben Modi. As a child, he helped his father in selling tea at the Vadnagar railway station, and according to sources, he ran a tea stall with his brother near the bus terminal. He discovered the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh when he was 8 years old and began attending its local training sessions, during which he met Lakman Rao Inamdar, popularly known as Vakil Sahib, who inducted him as Bal Swayam Sevak in the RSS and became his political mentor. And after 1971, Modi became a full-time campaigner for the RSS. In 1978, he received a Bachelor's of Arts degree in Political Science from School of Open Learning at University of Delhi. And 5 years later, in 1983, he received a Master's of Arts degree in Political Science from Gujarat University. Narendra Modi entered into the mainstream politics in 1975 when Prime Minister Indira Gandhi declared a state of emergency in India, which lasted till 1977. During the emergency, many of her political opponents were jailed and opposition groups were banned. Modi was appointed as the General Secretary of the Gujarat Lok Sanghar Samiti, an RSS committee coordinating opposition to the emergency in Gujarat. Shortly afterwards, the RSS was banned and Modi was forced to go underground in Gujarat and frequently travelled in disguise to avoid the arrest. Modi became the RSS Sambhag Pracharak in 1978, overseeing RSS activities in the areas of Surat and Vadodara, and got assigned by the RSS to the BJP in 1985. In 1987, Modi helped BJP in organizing the Ahmedabad municipal election campaign, which the BJP won very comfortably, which also resulted as a game changer for him, and he got elected as the organizing secretary of BJP's Gujarat unit. Narendra Modi rose within the party and became a member of the BJP's National Election Committee in 1990, helping organize Lal Krishan Advani's Rath Yatra and Murli Manohar Joshi's Ekta Yatra. His electoral strategy was considered central to the BJP victory in the 1995 state assembly elections. In November of that year, Modi was elected BJP's national secretary and transferred to New Delhi. After this, he was a part of the selection committee for the 1998 assembly elections in Gujarat. His strategy was credited as key to the BJP winning an overall majority in the 1998 elections. In 2001, the health of the Gujarat CM Keshubhai Patel was falling regularly and the BJP lost a few state assembly seats in by-elections. The BJP leadership sought a new candidate for the chief ministership and Modi was chosen as replacement. Although Lal Krishan Advani didn't agree with that decision and was concerned about Modi's lack of experience in government. At that time, Modi declined to be Patel's deputy CM, telling Advani and Atal Bihari Vajpayee that he was going to be fully responsible for Gujarat or not at all. On 3 October 2001, he replaced Patel as Chief Minister of Gujarat with the responsibility of preparing the BJP for the December 2002 elections. He was sworn in as CM on 7 October 2001 and entered the Gujarat State Legislature on 24 Feb 2002 by winning a by-election to the Rajkot constituency, defeating Ashwin Mehta of the Indian National Congress by 14,728 votes. On 27 Feb 2002, a train with several hundred passengers was burned near Godhra, killing approximately 60 people. The train carried a large number of Hindu pilgrims returning from Ayodhya after a religious ceremony at the site of the demolished Babri Masjid. In making a public statement after the incident, Modi declared it as a terrorist attack planned and orchestrated by local Muslims. The next day, the Vishv Hindu Parishad called for a band across the state. Riots began during the band and anti-Muslim violence spread through Gujarat. The state government stated
that 790 Muslims and 254 Hindus were killed, and according to the independent sources, this count was over 2,000. The Modi government imposed a curfew in 26 major cities, issued shoot-at-sight orders, and called for the army to patrol the streets, but was unable to prevent the violence from escalating. Modi's personal involvement in the 2002 events has continued to be debated. During the riots, Modi said that what's happening is a chain of action and reaction. The special investigation team questioned Modi in March 2010, and in May, it presented a report to the court finding no evidence against him. In the aftermath of the violence, there were widespread calls for Modi to resign as chief minister from within and outside the state. Modi submitted his resignation to the Gujarat governor S.S. Bhandari after the emergency meeting on 19 July 2002 and the state assembly was dissolved. After all this, the elections were held again in December 2002 and the BJP won 127 seats in the 182-member assembly. Modi won the Maninagar constituency receiving 1,13,589 votes and defeating Indian National Congress candidate Yatin Oza by 75,333 votes. On 22 December 2002, Bhandari swore Modi in for a second term. Narendra Modi's second term shifted from Hindutva to Gujarat's economic development. As a chief minister, Modi always favored privatization. His policies resulted in reducing corruption in the state. He established financial and technology parks in Gujarat, and in 2007 Vibrant Gujarat Summit, real estate investment deals worth 6.6 trillion rupees were signed. By December 2008, 5 lakh structures had been built, of which 1,13,738 were check dams. 60 of the 112 tehsils, which had depleted the water table in 2004, had regained their normal groundwater levels by 2010. In result, the state's production for the genetically modified cotton increased to become the largest in India, which led to Gujarat's agricultural sector growing at an average rate of 9.6% from 2001 to 2007. Public irrigation measures in central and southern Gujarat were less successful, such as the Sardar Sarovar Dam. Despite of that, Gujarat recorded agricultural growth of 10.97%. In 2008, Modi offered land in Gujarat to Tata Motors to set up plant manufacturing the Nano after a popular agitation had forced the company to move out of West Bengal, which affected as several other companies also followed Tata to Gujarat. Modi also changed the state system of power distribution. Modi government finished the process of bringing electricity to every village in the state and expanded the Jyoti Gram Yojana scheme. In this scheme, agricultural electricity was rationed fit scheduled irrigation demands, reducing its costs. In 2012 assembly elections, BJP again won 115 seats out of 182, continuing majority during his tenure. After his election as the Prime Minister, Modi resigned as the Chief Minister of Gujarat and as an MLA from Maninagar on 21 May 2014. Anandiben Patel succeeded him as the Chief Minister of Gujarat. Before the 2014 General Lok Sabha elections, the popularity of Gujarat development started a Modi wave among Indians, which led to the huge victory of Bharatiya Janata Party with a tally of 282 Lok Sabha seats, becoming the first party to win a majority on its own since 1984. After winning in the 2014 general elections, Modi came out as a global leader. He developed a positive image of India across the globe, strengthening the relations with most of the leaders. He showcased India as an investment destination for the whole world. Narendra Modi, who was denied a visa to enter the United States in 2005 on religious freedom grounds, was invited to the United States in 2014 to have a private dinner with Barack Obama and for a visit to the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial, and headlined a program at Madison Square Garden attended by more than 18,000 cheering members of the Indian diaspora. Narendra Modi is well known for being a leader who can take brave decisions like Jan Dhan Yojana, demonetization, GST, Make in India, and a new education policy. And he is also equally criticized for them too. This was the journey of Narendra Damodar Das Modi from selling tea on a railway station to becoming the 14th and the most famous Chief Minister of Gujarat, the 14th and current Prime Minister of India, the fashion leader of India, and a global leader.